VI कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ए डायोड और द VI कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ए पीएन जंक्शन, वी कैन कैलकुलेट द और फाइंड आउट द VI कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ए सेमीकंडक्टर डायोड बाय व्हेन द डायोड इज फॉरवर्ड बायस एंड आल्सो द VI कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स व्हेन द डायोड इज रिवर्स बायस. इन दिस केस द पीएन जंक्शन इज फॉरवर्ड बायस बिकॉज पी इज कनेक्टेड टू द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द बैटरी एंड एन इज कनेक्टेड टू द नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द बैटरी. इन फॉरवर्ड बायस वी गेट करेंट इन द ऑर्डर ऑफ मिली एम्पियर. सो ए मिली एमीटर इज कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज विद द डायोड एंड द वोल्ट मीटर इज कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल टू द डायोड. नाउ वी इंक्रीज द पोटेंशियल फ्रॉम द सोर्स सो दैट द करेंट विल ऑल्सो चेंजेस और इंक्रीजेस एंड द वेरिएशन ऑफ पोटेंशियल विद द करेंट इज प्लॉटेड इन ए ग्राफ एंड द ग्राफ इज कॉल्ड VI कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द सेमीकंडक्टर डायोड व्हेन द डायोड इज फॉरवर्ड बायस. दिस इज द सर्किट अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द पीएन जंक्शन और डायोड सेमीकंडक्टर डायोड व्हेन इट इज रिवर्स बायस. इन रिवर्स बायस वी हैव टू कनेक्ट द पी टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर टू द नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द बैटरी एंड एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर टू द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द बैटरी. इन रिवर्स बायस कंडीशन द करेंट वी गेट करेंट ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ माइक्रो एम्पियर. दैट इज वाई ए माइक्रो एमीटर इज कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज टू द सर्किट एंड ए वोल्ट मीटर इज कनेक्टेड टू द कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल टू द पीएन जंक्शन एंड द वेरिएशन ऑफ वोल्टेज एंड करेंट इज प्लॉटेड एंड द ग्राफ सो ऑब्टेंड इज कॉल्ड VI कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ए पीएन जंक्शन व्हेन द पीएन जंक्शन इज रिवर्स बायस. व्हेन यू प्लॉट ए ग्राफ टेकिंग द पोटेंशियल अलोंग एक्स एक्सिस एंड द करेंट इन वाई एक्सिस देन द शेप ऑफ द ग्राफ विल बी लाइक दिस एंड दिस ग्राफ इज कॉल्ड VI कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द सेमी कंडक्टर डायोड और पी एन जंक्शन डायोड. हियर वी हैव टेकन वोल्ट इन एक्स एक्सिस वोल्टेज ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ 0.2 वोल्ट 0.4 वोल्ट 0.6 वोल्ट 0.81 वोल्ट लाइक दिस एंड द करेंट इज ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ मिली एम्पियर 20 मिली एम्पियर 40 मिली एम्पियर 60 80 100 यू हैव टू टेक करेंट ऑफ दिस ऑर्डर. नाउ यू सी द इन दिस ग्राफ इन फॉरवर्ड बायस द करेंट फास्ट इंक्रीजेस वेरी स्लोली. यू सी इन फॉरवर्ड बायस द करेंट इंक्रीजेस वेरी स्लोली ऑलमोस्ट द करेंट इंक्रीज इन करेंट इज नेग्लिजिबल एंड एट ए वोल्टेज यू सी एट दिस वोल्टेज इन बिटवीन 0.6 एंड 0.8 दैट मीन्स इन एट 0.7 एट 0.7 वोल्ट द व्हिच इज कॉल्ड बेसिकली द थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज. दिस वोल्टेज इज कॉल्ड थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज और यू मे से द कॉट इन वोल्टेज. थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज और कॉट इन वोल्टेज. सो एट थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज द डायोड करेंट इंक्रीजेस एक्सपोनेंशियली. यू सी हाउ द डायोड करेंट इज इंक्रीजिंग एक्सपोनेंशियली एंड द इंक्रीज इन करेंट एक्सपोनेंशियल इंक्रीज इन करेंट इज फॉर अ वेरी स्मॉल इंक्रीज इन योर बायस वोल्टेज. इफ यू इंक्रीज द बायस वोल्टेज वेरी स्मॉल दैट मीन्स सपोज से 0.7 वोल्ट टू 0.8 वोल्ट द करेंट इज शार्पली इंक्रीजिंग. यू सी हाउ द करेंट इज शार्पली इंक्रीजिंग एंड इफ यू टेक द जर्मानियम सेमीकंडक्टर देन द थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज विल बी नियरली 0.2 वोल्ट. यू विल गेट द थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज हियर एंड फॉर सिलिकॉन सेमीकंडक्टर द थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज इज 0.7 हियर 0.77 वोल्ट एंड दिस ग्राफ इज फॉर सिलिकॉन सेमीकंडक्टर वेयर यू हैव थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज 0.7 वोल्ट इन व्हिच द करेंट इज इंक्रीजिंग शार्पली. As we have discussed earlier, the current in forward bias is basically due to the diffusion current, which is of the order of milliampere. And in Faroda Bypass also you have drift current, and the magnitude of the drift current or the order of the drift current is very small, that is of the order of microampere. That is why it can be neglected. The drift current is neglected in comparison to the diffusion current in Faroda Bypass. And I have also discussed that due to the electric field at the junction, at the PN junction, the minority charge carriers moves towards the majority side, producing drift current. And the order of the drift current is very small, of the order of microampere. And if you reverse the voltage, that is, if you make the voltage negative, then you will get the reverse bias. That is the VI characteristic in the reverse bias. When the diode is reverse bias, this curve will show you the VI characteristics of the reverse bias. And you see in reverse bias, the current is not very much dependent on the applied voltage. You increase the applied voltage from here 0 to here nearly 80 volt, but the current is not changing. The current is constant. The reverse bias current is constant, and it is of the order of microampere. As I have discussed earlier, even a small voltage is sufficient to sweep the minority carrier from one side of the junction to the other side, and the current depends on the concentration of the minority carrier on either side of the junction. I have discussed how the minority charge carriers move towards the majority side due to the electric field at this junction. That means here the electron moves from the minority charge carrier, electron move from P side to N side, and the hole from the N side to P side, and producing the drift current, which is of the order of microampere in reverse bias condition. And you see from this graph, the current under reverse bias, this current under reverse bias is voltage independent. It does not depend upon this voltage. And it is voltage independent up to a critical value. Okay, up to a critical value of the reverse bias voltage. And this voltage is called the breakdown voltage. This voltage VBR, it is called the breakdown voltage. So it is very important that the reverse bias current is independent of the applied voltage, and it depends upon the concentration of the minority carrier. But at a voltage called the breakdown voltage, the current, that is the reverse bias current, then that increases sharply. You see, there is sharp increase in the reverse bias current. That is why the general purpose diode are not used beyond the reverse saturation current region. The general purpose diode we basically use up to this. It is not used beyond the reverse saturation current. But there are some special purpose PN junction diode which are called Zener diode, which is used for this saturation current. That is operated beyond this breakdown voltage. We will discuss about the special purpose PN junction diode, that is the Zener diode, later on. But for the general purpose PN junction diode, we use the reverse bias current within the breakdown voltage. Remember, this reverse saturation current, it is nothing but the, it is defined as the current which remains constant. This reverse saturation current means the current which remains constant with the change in bias voltage. Okay, if you change the reverse bias voltage, the reverse saturation current remains constant. Then the most important thing in VI characteristics of the diode is the dynamic resistance. Now, what is dynamic resistance? The small change in voltage delta V to the small change in current delta I, the ratio of the small change in voltage delta V to the small change in current delta I is called the dynamic resistance. So whether the diode is forward bias or it is reverse bias, we can calculate the small change in voltage. So if this is the straight line graph, linear graph, we can calculate the small change in voltage here and what is the small change in current here. And the basically we find out the resistance and when the device is running, that is the dynamic resistance is the runtime resistance, that is the resistance offered by a device during the particular period of time. Okay, the runtime resistance or the resistance during a particular period of time where you consider the change in voltage to the change in current. How it differs from the static resistance? Static resistance is the ohmic resistance and is a constant at a given temperature. But the dynamic resistance is not constant. It is the runtime resistance. We basically calculate the resistance at a particular period of time. So dynamic resistance Rd is equal to delta V by delta I. Let us work out this problem to know what is the to know in detail about the dynamic resistance. The VI characteristics of a silicon diode is shown in the figure given below, and calculate the resistance of the diode when the diode current is 15 milliampere and when the diode voltage is minus 10 volt. So in this figure the VI graph is given. The voltage is taken along the x-axis and the current is taken along y-axis. The voltage is in volt and the current is in milliampere when it is forward bias, and when it is reverse bias the voltage is up here given along x-axis in negative direction, negative x-axis direction voltage is taken, and its current is taken along the negative y-axis, and here the current is in microampere. And there is sharp increase in the current at about 0.7 volt. You see 0.7 volt, which is your threshold voltage, and at 0.7 volt there is a sharp increase in current, means it is a silicon diode. It must be a silicon diode. And here we have to find out the resistance of the diode. That is the dynamic resistance or runtime resistance when the current, diode current is equal to 15 milliampere here. When the diode current is 15 milliampere, you have to calculate the diode resistance or the runtime resistance. We know the diode resistance or dynamic resistance is equal to the change in voltage divided by the change in current. Here at 0.8 volt the current is 20 milliampere, and at 0.7, this is 0.7, at 0.7 volt the current is 10 milliampere. So the difference in voltage is 0.1 volt, 0.8 volt minus 0.7 volt. So difference in voltage is 0.1 volt, and the difference in current is 20 milliampere minus 10 milliampere. So it is equal to 10 milliampere. So the difference in current is 10 milliampere and the difference in voltage is 0.1 volt. So the dynamic resistance will be equal to 0.1 volt. This is 0.1 volt divided by your 10 milliampere. So 0.1 volt divided by 10 milliampere, this will be equal to 10 ohm. So the resistance of the diode or the dynamic resistance when the current is equal to 15 milliampere is equal to 10 ohm. Now we calculate the dynamic resistance of the diode when it is reverse bias. So dynamic resistance is equal to change in voltage divided by the change in current. But here there is no change in voltage. Here the voltage is given 10 volt and the current here given is 1 microampere. So at minus 10 volt the current is 1 microampere. So the diode resistance will be equal to 10 volt minus 10 volt divided by minus 1 microampere, and that will be equal to 10 to the power 7 ohm. But in calculation you should take the magnitude only without taking the sign. So you may write diode resistance will be equal to 10 volt divided by 1 microampere, that is equal to 10 to the power 7 ohm. So you see, in when the diode is reverse bias, the resistance is very high, that is of the order of 10 to the power minus 7 ohm. But when it is forward bias, the resistance is very small, that is of the order of 10 ohm. So this is a very important property in diode. The forward bias resistance is very small and reverse bias resistance is very high. That is why it is used as a rectifier, because it converts alternating current into direct current when it is when the for the positive half cycle of the AC the diode conducts current, and for the negative half cycle of the AC it does not current because of its reverse biasing. That is why it acts as a rectifier. The most use of the diode is a rectifier, which will be discussed in the next video.